Good morning. It's gorgeous out here and it's 6:30 or something and I'm off.
But in no time at all, you became my girl. Me and you, one-on-one against the world. Talking on the telephone for hours at a time, and else I was at your house and you was at mine. And then came the arguments and all kinds of problems. Besides making love, we had nothing in common.
Santa Barbara, pulling off on the side of the road, sitting on my cooler, taking a little food break. Because we became friends. How many of us have them? Friends. How many of us have them? Friends. Ones we can depend on. Friends. I think I have some. Santa Barbara. Just kind of pulled over. Wow. Lots of beautiful palm trees. Beautiful. Awesome boardwalk so everybody can just run by the water. They're just everywhere in California here. Santa Barbara, that's where Allison, my buddy Allison's parents live here. Skateboard park, look boys. I used to love that when you were younger. What are you doing, digging in the sand, buddy?
Not her, her. She was just digging too. They're trying to bury this bone.
I saw the Irish
said
a big.
Yeah, I don't know why he won't do it, Sam.
He knows he's being observed. Ooh. Interesting plant. Wow. Looks kind of like a hairy, crooked penis. Oh, I'm getting delirious here. Sorry. Look at this awesome, huge, huge marina. And the weather. Oh, the weather. Eat your heart out, Washingtonians. I miss you, though. Tell you what, though. I will be back in the summer to go to the beautiful San Juan Islands. They're the best, man. We have such great San Juan Islands up in Washington State. I suppose every place in the world is beautiful. In a different way. That's the beauty of God's creation. But I am enjoying the weather. I know, I'm rubbing it in. That's okay, I get you. Well, here's a lovely place that I am being hosted. Wow, free of charge. This beautiful place right on the beach on Solana. This wonderful family is letting me stay. I am so lucky. Wow. Look at this. It's a huge house, a huge Airbnb. Wow. And it is literally like, wow, this is the bedroom. There's a hot tub outside and a barbecue. And it's like a minute walk to the beach. Yeah, I don't think I could afford to stay here if it wasn't for that. How kind. That's a huge place. And I have 3 nights. I'm only going to stay here if it's not rented out, obviously. But tonight for sure. And if I'm lucky, another couple nights. Here's another bedroom. And another bedroom and another bedroom, but I am going to stay in the master bedroom and I'm going to cook myself a nice little meal tonight and, yep, watch this great big huge TV and get showered up and, wow, very, very cool. Thank you, Benji.
Wow, this TV is huge. I'm trying to, like, I should go have a hot tub, but and a bath or something. But I'm just so relaxing here.
So
It's amazing what happens when you put yourself out there. I just, you know, was so afraid to make changes. And I have so many friends that are like stuck in these horrible relationships, afraid to change stuff. And I put myself out there and I made some changes, and interesting people you meet, interesting things that happen to you. I was a little worried. I'm still a little worried. I've had an adventure and everything, but I'm going to go to a place where I, you know, I'm going to live in a place I don't know anybody at, in somebody's house. And dang it. I hope I don't get the coronavirus. And yesterday I had a really rough time, because I tell you what, I just wanted to like get home and cuddle my kitty and be back to before Raj got ill when I was in San Diego last time. But it was such a sudden change going down there, flying down there, not having any of my stuff. And sometimes in life, you know, you can't ask why did something happen? You just need to say, it's not about me, it's not my problem. And you just need to move on, because everybody has their own story. I learned that from this place called Impact Theory. I used to do a lot of like self-help type stuff, and I kind of forgot about it. I think first time I went through my divorce, when my ex had an affair, it was just really hard. And I got away from it. This time I got back into it. We all have stories that we tell ourselves that aren't even necessarily true. Like, oh, it's going to be bad and I can't change and I can't do this and I can't do that. You know, and those stories aren't necessarily true. So we need to tell our minds, stop. I'm going to create another story, because that's all it is. It's my story. You know, and everybody's going to tell you, you can't do this and you can't do that. And hey, maybe this will suck. Maybe I will end up getting in my little van and going back home. But you know what? At least I tried. And right now it's worked out. I'm in this gorgeous Airbnb that's right on Sonoma Beach. It's probably $1,000 a night for free, because I put myself out there and met some people. And yeah, I was really afraid yesterday, but today I'm better. And my friend Lorraine said, you know what? Maybe this person that you're going to see, and you know who I'm talking about, and I'm going to actually ask him to be part of my YouTube channel. I don't know if him and his family want to do that, but he had a traumatic injury, and he's been praying to get out of this place. And maybe, she said, I'm the answer to his prayer, and I've always wanted to help somebody. And maybe all the suffering that I did in the hospital, maybe it was worth something, because maybe I can help him. And that would give me a lot of joy, you know? So life is really interesting. Instead of falling apart, like I said at the beginning of these vlogs, and instead of going why, I just went, you know, there's always changes in life and we shouldn't be afraid of them. And where is it that I want to be? And I thought, I want to be in San Diego because it's beautiful there. So ask yourself, where is it that I really want to be? What is it that I really want to do? And then put those thoughts out there. And I don't believe in like woo-woo affirmation type stuff. But I tell you what, your actions are determined. Your outcome is determined by your actions. And your actions are determined by your feelings. And your feelings are determined by your thoughts. So if you have nasty, weird thoughts, you have to ask yourself, are they really true? You know, and sometimes you don't even know your thoughts, but if you feel shitty, you just go like, what is it that's making me feel shitty? It's the thoughts that I'm having, and then change your thoughts. And it's hard in the beginning, but it actually gets easier and easier. And then put one step and one foot in front of the other, and you change the thoughts, and then the thoughts change your feelings, and your feelings then change your actions, and then your actions determine what's going to happen. So that's what I've been learning on Impact Theory. and I've been putting it into actions, and within the last year I've lost 50 pounds. I've gotten into shape. I have changed the way I eat. I've changed the way I think. I've changed what I do. I'm happier, healthier, and all that's a huge controversy through my parents dying, three sets of them, and my best friend, and Raj getting ill, and spending a year in the almost out in the hospital, and the family not treating me very well, and just all this, and yet I was able to get through that. So your attitude of positivity or negativity does a lot. And when I went through my divorce, I did the opposite. I went to this sleepy little town, and which I love, by the way, nothing to do with that, but I'm just saying, and I just drank too much and it just wasn't good. And it was great because I had my kids there, but there's nothing for me now. My kids are not there anymore. And sometimes in your life, there's nothing there and you need to change. And if it's on your mind to do that, do it. I'm gonna go have a hot tub, finish my glass of wine, and have a much needed shower and have a good night's sleep in this awesome bed. Love you all. And do subscribe and like, because it makes me feel loved and I want to feel loved. Love you guys. Bye. Okay, so I'm in their hot tub. Oh, this is so nice. Considering I've just hung out in my van for the last few nights and a scuzzy motel. Mind you, I do love my van, but I have to say, this is very, very cool and so unexpected that I get to stay here. Very cool. You know what's cool? There are palm trees. Palm trees that I can see from my hot tub, or the hot tub I'm in, and oh, the moon is shining through. Look at this. This is ultra cool. Well, cheers and good night. And as my friend Tom Bilyeu from Impact Theory would say, be legendary. Someday, maybe I can meet him and he can interview me.